Hi, welcome to Analog Communication course. In this video, we will learn the concept of single sideband modulation. So first, we will see the spectrum of conventional AM. Here, this is the spectrum of conventional AM. Assuming the spectrum of message signal is like this, which is band limited to WH. So the spectrum of conventional AM contains three things: upper sideband, lower sideband, and the carrier component. Similarly, if we observe the spectrum of DSB SC, double sideband with suppressed carrier. Okay. So in this case, we suppress the carrier, but we have two sidebands, upper sideband and lower sideband. Okay. So from AM to DSB, the advantage is that we are saving the carrier power. But if we observe the transmission bandwidth, both in AM and DSB SC, the transmission bandwidth is 2W, where W is the maximum frequency component of message signal. That means the transmission bandwidth here is 2 times the message signal bandwidth. 2 times the message signal bandwidth. Okay. But if we observe clearly, the upper sideband and lower sideband are symmetrical to each other. Okay, not each other, they are symmetrical with respect to carrier frequency. Right? So, for example, if USB is given to us, then we can construct the LSB. So based on this fact, what we can do is, instead of transmitting these two sidebands, upper sideband and lower sideband together, we can transmit only one sideband, either upper or lower. That means this is the spectrum of DSB SC. So this is FC, carrier frequency. So just I am writing these limits only for positive frequencies, and this is upper sideband and this is lower sideband. Okay. So instead of transmitting these two sidebands, if we could transmit only the upper sideband like this, or only the lower sideband, then just I am writing the limits here. So in this case, this is only upper sideband, this is only lower sideband. So in this case, the transmission bandwidth is equal to the message signal bandwidth. In this case also, the transmission bandwidth is equal to the message signal bandwidth. Just if we compare this with the double sideband, in this case the bandwidth is equal to twice the message signal bandwidth. Okay. So this is SSB, this is also SSB, this is DSB. Okay. So SSB, where we have transmitted only the upper sideband components. This is SSB, where we have transmitted the lower sideband components. So here we can clearly identify that the transmission bandwidth in SSB is half that is required for DSB. We are saving on bandwidth. Okay. So obviously, if we are saving something, so something opposite should occur. I mean, this transmission bandwidth we are saving at the cost of the complexity of transmitter and receiver. Okay, so how to generate these SSB waveforms? There are two methods. One is frequency discrimination method. Second one is phase discrimination method. Okay. So first we study the frequency discrimination method. So this is a simple method. In this method, what we do is first we generate the DSB signal, then using a band pass filter we will select the either upper sideband or lower sideband. So this is the block diagram. If you observe, see here, this at this point, say call this as say V of T for example. So this V of T is a DSB signal. This DSB signal is passed through a band pass filter to generate SSB signal. Okay, so just I draw the spectrum of first the DSB signal. So this is a DSB signal spectrum, assuming, see this as my message signal spectrum. Okay, so this is my message signal spectrum. Assuming this as message signal spectrum, so whatever I am drawing now is the spectrum of DSB signal. Okay, now I pass this, say as per the block diagram, I am calling this as V of T. It is nothing but the spectrum of DSB signal. Now I am using a band pass filter. Okay, so I select the band pass filter assuming only ideal case. Okay, I am taking all ideal conditions. The band pass filter is something like this. Okay, so its gain is 1 for frequencies f greater than fc, and its gain is 0. Its gain is 0 for frequencies f less than fc. Then what is the resultant spectrum? So the resultant spectrum will be, you are left with only the upper sideband portion because your band pass filter is suppressing the lower sideband portions. Okay, so this is fc plus w. Okay, similarly for negative frequencies. Okay, so if you choose an appropriate filter to remove upper side bands, then you are left with only the lower side bands. It all depends on the type of filter that you chose, right sir? So this is frequency discrimination method. But here, whatever the band pass filter characteristic that I have drawn, it is ideal, right? We cannot design, practically we cannot design a band pass filter, say, which goes from a gain of 0 to 1 abruptly. Okay, definitely practically it should go like this, correct? So in this case, I change the color. Say for example, if this is my practical band pass filter, then part of lower side band also coming here, right? So obviously we cannot transmit the signals whose spectrum is like this. Instead of saying like this, whose spectrum contains significant low frequency components, we cannot transmit those signals using SSB. Then for what type of signals this SSB modulation technique is suitable? So kind of signals where there are no low frequency components, something like this, only assumption I am making. Okay, if this is my message signal spectrum, then first I draw the spectrum of DSB. So the DSB spectrum is same. I mean, the message signal spectrum should be symmetrical with respect to FC, like this, and similarly with respect to minus FC. Correct. Now I take a band pass filter which is not ideal, even a practical one. So for example, it is something like this. Okay, so to be more specific, say the lower frequency is A, higher frequency is B, minus A, minus B. So this is FC plus A, this is FC minus A. Okay, so if this roll off is within the limits of from my FC minus A to FC plus A, so you are getting approximately a gap of 2A for this roll off to occur. Okay, so which is sufficient enough to design practical band pass filters, right? So then comfortably you will get your desired upper sideband like this, right? So we can transmit these type of signals. Instead of saying these type of signals, the signals which do not contain components, significant components at low frequencies, we can use this SSB modulation technique. But what signals do not contain very low frequency components? So a practical application is voice. Generally our voice spectrum significant portion starts from 300 Hz to say 3.5 kHz. Okay, so you are getting a gap, so I call this a spectral gap. You are getting a spectral gap of 600 Hz in this case. Okay, if you can design a band pass filter where this transition roll off is within 600 Hz, then comfortably you can get the upper sideband and lower sidebands without any distortion. Okay, so this is one method, and the other method is phase discrimination method. So before going into the block diagram, in the time domain we can represent the SSB signal as, okay, just I am ignoring the constants, so m of t into cos 2 pi fct plus or minus m hat of t into sin 2 pi fct. This is the time domain equation. Just I am ignoring, as I said, constant amplitude of a carrier and 1 by 2 factor and all. So here one unknown thing is m hat of t. M hat of t is the Hilbert transform of m of t. Okay, so we will see the Hilbert transform concept in a separate lecture. Okay, so based on this equation we generate SSB wave. Okay, so in the frequency domain, so if m of f is the spectrum of m of t, then the spectrum of Hilbert transform is minus j signal function of f into m of f. So anyway, signal function is plus or minus 1, right? So in simple words, the spectrum of Hilbert transformed signal is same as the spectrum of m of f except in phase. That phase is nothing but, I mean, what is the phase difference is plus or minus 90 degrees. Okay, so based on this equation, so this is the block diagram. See, I am giving m of t into cos 2 pi fct. So first term, this is first term. First term is generated here. And second term, second term is m hat of t. So the nothing but a phase degrees, plus or minus 90 degrees phase shifter network I implemented here. Okay, so I got m hat of t. And here I am getting sin 2 pi fct, so second term I am getting here. So plus or minus some adder, I am getting SSB. Okay, So why plus or minus? Because SSB signal can be either USB or LSB. SSB signal may contain only USB components or only LSB components, right? So if it is minus, USB, if it is plus, LSB. Okay. So these are the two different methods using which we can generate the SSB waves. In the next video, we will discuss the demodulation technique for SSB waves.